हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर मिलन वी पटेल। आई एम इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर सिस्टम फ्रॉम द महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 6, पावर फैक्टर फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट पावर क्वालिटी एंड मैनेजमेंट हैविंग अ सब्जेक्ट कोड 2180911 ऑफ द बीई सेमेस्टर 8 इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। So today we will discuss example from the chapter number 6, power factor of the power quality management subject. And this example was asked in GTU examination of winter 2017. So now, example, a 100 kilowatt induction motor is working at 0.7 power factor. If the power factor is to be improved to 0.95, with capacitors, how much shunt capacitor in kVAr is needed? So here one induction motor with rating 100 kilowatt is given and its power factor is 0.7. Now we have to improve the power factor to 0.95 from the 0.7. So now how much leading kVAr is required? So we have to find the reactive power in terms of kVAr for the improving the power factor from the 0.7 to 0.95. So now given data are P is equal to 100 kilowatt, power factor 1 is equal to 0.7, power factor 2 is equal to 0.95. So power factor 1 is the power factor from where we have to improve it. Power factor 2 is equal to 0.95. So we have to improve power factor from 0.7 to 0.95. 0.7 to 0.95. So now we know the equation of power factor. From the power factor power triangle, power factor 1 cos phi 1 is given by P1 divided by S. P means active power, S means apparent power. So now we know the value of power factor 1 is 0.7. So our equation will become 0.7 is equal to 100 divided by S. S means apparent power. So now from this equation we can find the value of the apparent power. S is given by 142.85 kilovolt ampere. Now again we will find the power factor angle for first case, for 0.7 power factor. So phi 1 is given by cos inverse 0.7, and from this equation we will get the value of phi 1 is equal to 45.57 degree. And from this value of phi we can find the value of sine phi 1 is equal to sine 45.57. the value for the sine phi 1 is 0.7. So now reactive power q1 is equal to s sine phi 1. Now reactive power Q1 is given by S sin phi 1. This is the reactive power corresponding the value of the power factor 0.7, and it is given by S sin phi 1. So put the value of S and sin phi 1 in this equation, we will get the value 142.85 into 0.7. The value for the reactive power Q1 is given by 102 kVA means kilovolt ampere reactive, kVAr. Now power factor 2 is given by 0.95. So we have to improve our power factor 0.7 to 0.95. So we have to find the value of the power factor angle corresponding to the value of the power factor 0.95. So phi 2 is given by cos inverse 0.95, and the value for the power factor angle is 18.19 degree. 18.19 degree. Now, according to the power factor angle 18.19, we have to find reactive power Q2. Reactive power Q2. So, reactive power Q2 is given by S sine phi 2. S sine phi 2. So, S is equal to 142.85 in bracket sine 18.19. So, reactive power Q2 is given by 44.60 kVAr. 44.60 kVAr. So, this is the reactive power for the 0.95 power factor. So, now the shunt capacitor required delta Q for improving the power factor from 0.7 to 0.95 is given by delta Q is equal to Q1 minus Q2. So, Q1 is equal to 102 kVAr and Q2 is equal to 44.60 kVAr. So, the delta Q is equal to 57.40 kVAr. So, this is the value of reactive power required to improve the power factor from 0.7 to 0.95. So, this capacitor value is 57.40 kVAr leading required for improving the power factor from 0.7 to 0.95. I hope you understood this example. This is the most important example for the 7 marks. So, I hope you understood.